Welcome to teachmeselenium.com. In this video, I will demonstrate how to use CSS Selector to locate elements in the page. In the previous video, how to use XPath to locate elements in the page, I introduced you to the world of XPath. If you have not watched that video, I have put the link in the description. Check it out. While XPath is powerful, the downside is at times XPath can be slower. CSS Selector is also as powerful as XPath, and the best thing is it is relatively faster than XPath. Before moving forward, let us first understand what is a CSS Selector. Well, every modern web page is built of CSS. CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheets. CSS defines the style, for instance size, fonts, color, width, etc. of the elements inside the HTML. A CSS Selector can select a single element by using its ID or multiple elements by using their class to apply styles on a group of elements. It can also use tags of the elements along with its attributes to locate the elements. And the best thing is WebDriver supports locating elements by using CSS selectors. So these are some examples of CSS selectors. So the first example, the first part H1 is the CSS selector. So it selects all H1 tags inside the HTML. The code written inside curly braces denotes the style. So it is basically saying all H elements that has H1 tags will have a color white and it will have text align center. Similarly, for the second example, the CSS selector is A. So it is selecting all A tags or anchor tags in the HTML. So it is selecting all anchor tags and it is applying a style that is written inside the curly braces. So it is saying all anchor tags will have font family and a font size specified by this line of codes. So let us launch a browser and get our hand dirty. So I will launch Google Chrome and go to this website teachmeselenium.com/automation-practice and try to locate different elements in this page using CSS selector. So let us first try to locate this field, first name field. So I'll right click over here and select inspect. So it has opened Chrome Developer Tools. So as we can see, this element has a tag input. It has an ID first name and it has some other attributes also. So let us first learn how we can use ID attribute to locate an element. So I will press Ctrl F to open the finder where I can find by string, selector or XPath. So in CSS selector, hash denotes an ID. So as this element has this ID first name, so I will simply type hash first name, press enter. So as we can see, it has highlighted this element. So our first learning is if we want to locate an element using ID attribute, so I will type hash followed by the value of that ID for CSS selector. Let us now try to locate the second element, last name. So I will click on this icon to inspect it and move mouse over this element. Okay, so this is also an input. It has an input tag and it has a class attribute whose value is last name. So I cannot type in hash last name because last name is not an ID, it is a class. In CSS selector, dot denotes a class. So I will type in dot followed by the value of this class and this is last name. Press enter. So as we can see, it was able to highlight this element. So this is our second learning, that whenever we want to locate an element using its class attribute in CSS selector, I will type in dot followed by the value of that class. Now some of you who are familiar with HTML and CSS may argue multiple elements can have same class name. So that is the reason we have CSS, so that we can group multiple elements and apply in a style. So this approach will not uniquely identify a single element. Well, you're right. So that is the reason we can combine the tag name along with ID or class. In this example, the CSS selector will select an element that has a class value of last name. It doesn't care what the tag name is. In our example, the tag name is input. So if we want to specify the tag name to make the search results unique, we can do that. So first we will type tag name followed by, if we are searching for an ID, I will type in hash But in this example, I'm searching with a class. So I'll type in dot and the class name was last name. So as we can see, it has successfully highlighted this element. So this is our third learning. So if we want to specify tag name along with ID or class, so I will first type in the tag name followed by hash for ID or dot for class followed by the value of that ID or class. Now some of you may ask, hey, what if that element has neither ID nor class attribute? Well, let's try to locate some other element. So I will click on the inspect and let's try to locate this radio button for female. So as we can see, it has an input tag, but it has a different attributes, name, type, value. It doesn't have an ID or class attribute, so we cannot use dot or hash. In this case, I will type in the tag name is input followed by a square bracket, then the name of the attribute. So the attribute name was name equals the value of that attribute. So the value is gender. Press enter. So as you can see, we have three different elements that matches this CSS selector. So the first one was for gender female, second was for gender male, and this was the third option. So to make the CSS selector unique, I'll have to use a different attribute. So this is also an important learning. Like if we have a CSS selector and that is selecting different elements, how we can distinguish? Well, if we observe the code snippets carefully, all three elements have the same tag. They have the same attribute name. All name attributes have the same value gender. Type is also same radio, but this is a different, the value part. So we can use this attribute. Let us modify this selector. So instead of name attribute, I will use value. And the value that we are targeting is female. So let's copy it. Paste it here and press enter. As we can see, we were able to uniquely identify this element. Now let's try to locate some other element. So I'll click on inspect icon and move mouse over. Let's say we want to locate this checkbox for Java. So as we can see, it has an input tag and some attributes, name, whose value is language underscore Java, then type, and then value. So those who have watched my previous video for XPath, the link is in the description, they may ask, hey, XPath has a powerful feature of locating elements by using partial value. So there was a contains function. So what is the equivalent in CSS? Let's say I want to search for this element, but I don't want to use the full value, that is language Java. I want to use a partial value. So how we can do that? So let's first inspect this element by using its full value. So the tag name is input. It has a name attribute and whose value is language underscore Java. As we can see, it was able to locate this element. So if I want to make a search by using a partial value, let's say I want to omit this language part and I want to just search using this Java. So I'll have to type in asterisk equals Java, press enter. So as we can see, it was able to locate this element. So this is one more learning. So if you want to search for a partial value, you need to append asterisk before equal sign. So this is the syntax. Watch it carefully. This is an important learning because in real world example, you will find instances when the properties of an object gets changed dynamically. So some part of it is static while some part of it is a dynamic. For instance, it may happen this element is getting rendered dynamically, and every time we refresh this page, it suffixes some value, let's say language underscore Java underscore 123, or prefixes some value, let's say programming language underscore Java. So some part is same while some part is dynamic. So we can use this partial search method using asterisk. In XPath, there is one more method starts with that search for an element based on the prefixed value. So let's try to search the same element, the checkbox Java, differently. So I will type in the tag name that was input, and it has a value attribute whose value was Java. Press enter. It was able to highlight this element. Now, what if the value for value is also dynamic? So today we are seeing Java, tomorrow it may be Java underscore 123 or Java underscore XYZ or Java ABC. So the bottom line is the prefix is same, but the suffix is getting changed. So in this case, we will write this caret sign. I will not write the full name. I will write only JAV and press enter. So it was able to highlight this element. So this is one more learning. So if I want to search for an element whose prefix is same, but the suffix is dynamic, so I can search for it by using this caret sign. So it is similar to starts with function in XPath. If you don't want to use the tag name, or if we suspect the tag name may change in future, we can also omit it. And we can just write the attribute and the value. We have seen this example by searching for this element by using ID or class. So this is similar to the wildcard search using asterisk in XPath. Now, if you want to search for an element whose prefix is getting changed, but the suffix is same, so you can search by using a dollar sign, change the selection criteria. So I will use a name attribute. And use the last portion. So it should end with Java. I don't care how it starts. Press enter. As we can see, it was able to search for this element.
Those who are comfortable with XPath or have seen my XPath video may ask this question. Hey, is there any way to locate a child of an element or a grandchild? Well, the answer is yes. So let me show you. Let's inspect an element of, let's select this element. Okay, so as we can see, this has a tag of h5. And it is inside another element div. So div is parent for this element. So I want to select the child of this div element that happens to be h5. So I'll first locate this parent element. So I'll type in the tag name. Followed by its class value. So for class, I will use dot. And the class value is entry content. Press enter. So as we can see, we were able to highlight this element. Now, to select an immediate child of any element, we type an arrow sign followed by the child element. So I can use the tag name of this element. So I'll type in h5. Press enter. As we can see, we were able to locate this element. So this is one more learning. So if I want to select an immediate child of an element, so I will first locate the parent element, followed by an arrow icon, and then the locator of child element. Now, what if I don't want to select an immediate child of a parent element, but I want to select a grandchild or any other element that is nested deep inside the element. So let's expand it. So let's say I want to select this anchor tag, and it is not the immediate child of div, so its parent is p, and p is the child of div. So if we relate it with XPath, so I'm demonstrating an example where in XPath we write double forward slash. So like the previous example, I will first locate the parent element. Now to select a child element that is not the immediate child, so I will not type in arrow symbol. I'll simply put a space and then write the locator of the child element, for it is an anchor. Press enter. As we can see, we were able to locate this element. Now, if you are attentive enough, you must have noticed that this locator is not able to uniquely identify this element. We have four different elements that matches this locator. So we need to change this locator. So I'm not demonstrating how we can do that. I'm leaving it as an assignment for you. Coming to assignments, I want to give a couple of more assignments. So your job is to locate all elements inside this page, right from this header, all input boxes, radio buttons, checkboxes, drop-down list, button, different links. So write CSS locator to locate all these elements. Please feel free to post your CSS selectors in comments. I will be happy to review them. If you face any issue while constructing CSS selectors, please post what all options you have tried and where you have failed. I will be happy to help you. So guys, I explained most of the things that you will be using with CSS selectors throughout your Selenium journey. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. Happy learning.